Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jane Lawrence, aka Juicy Jane, and I come with a lot of juice. In today's episode, I will be giving you seven types of D, seven types of shapes, and, you know, great love-making position for different shapes and sizes. So if you like the sound of that, please give this video a huge thumbs up and subscribe. Hit the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a video here. You want to be the first person to see my video drop. Be right back. Welcome back and thanks for staying tuned. Now, shall we establish the fact that size does not always guarantee orgasm, all right? Okay, I just had to get that off the way, okay? Now listen, a more modestly sized individual who knows how to use their size well enough can help their partner achieve a better orgasm than someone who has a really huge one and isn't putting in the work. You know, this week we've been talking about the D. I just really need you to know the importance of having, you know, whatever shape that you have, whatever size that you have, and using it. It's not only beneficial that you have size, but you need to know how to work with what you have. And that's the reason why I am emphasizing on this. And also note that it's not just about the size. Shape is just as important to figure out which position will potentially coil up your toes and that of your partner, which one will be painful for your spouse, and how much manual or clitoral stimulation your partner will be needing. So I urge you to never get caught up in specific measurements or making comparison, which are likely to create anxiety that would interfere with your bedroom performance and your pleasure. All right? Instead, maximize what God has given to you. All right, whatever God has given to you, He knows that you have a spouse, you know, specifically designed for your size, your shape, and length. All right, I tell you, the magic is in your position. Certain positions and skills will make your love making mind blowing for you and your spouse. And with that being said and done, here is the first D size and shape. It's called the churro. These are the type of D that have thin girth and width from the base to the tip. And the length varies. It could be long, it could be short. Now, one of the reasons why people enjoy penetrative sex is the fullness factor. So when someone has a thin D, their spouse may not be able to feel it against their kitty wall. And if that partner has delivered children, it might mean that their kitty walls may have widened or they might have become a lot looser. So they wouldn't feel very much stimulated. So if this is your current situation, then this is what you will need to do. If you have a thin D, then it's best for your partner to keep your thighs close together, because this will often than not narrow the canal, thereby creating a friction and intensifying, you know, some sort of sensation for you and your woman. Doggy style is also a great position, especially if you want to stimulate the clit with your hands at the same time, because penetration alone is most often not going to be enough. Some form of clit stimulation is usually needed in order to orgasm for women. So if you're on a longer side but your D is slim, then also try a position called the bandolier. The bandolier position is like this. The woman who is being penetrated lies on her back so that you can enter while you're on your knees. That way they can tuck their knees together and place their feet on your chest. This position does not only tighten the kitty, but it also lets your partner be in control of how far you can penetrate. And that can prevent you from, you know, either bumping their cervix and causing them pain. Do you get what I mean? Now, the second type of D is called the Italian salami. Now, this is a type that has above average width and length. If you have this kind of D, you might be the envy of others in a locker room. But the truth is that someone who is well endowed oftentimes has to be very, very careful when they're proceeding during intercourse. And of course, I do understand that in the heat of the moment, there's often the urge to thrust harder and deeper, but a larger D can hit that cervix and cause pain. You need to know that. But on the upside of things, since the clit is very close to the vagina opening, a large D size is more likely to push against it, causing more pleasure to the woman, all right? So that's one of the advantages of having that kind of shape and size. Now, if this is your shape and size, this is your action plan. The key with a big D is to make sure that your partner can control the angle, the depth, and the pace of your thrusting. So you being on top, either squatting or kneeling, is going to give your woman the choice of how deep she wants you to go. And because the frenulum, that is the underside of the head of the D, has the densest nerve endings, right, a more shallow penetration wouldn't affect your ability to come or to climax. Do you get my drift? So spooning is also ideal for a man with your type, shape and size, because you can't enter too far. Plus, it gives you easy access to fondle with your partner's chest and with her clit. And then your chances of orgasm will increase as they adjust to your size. However, whatever position you prefer, have lube on hand. With a big D like that, my brother, it is not negotiable. Non-negotiable that you have lube. Then the third type of D shape is called the cucumber. It has average girth and length. It doesn't vary in width along the shaft, all right? It basically maintains a constant girth from top to bottom. And that's talking about getting very lucky, ladies, if you have this type, because almost every position is a good one for a cucumber shaped D. So if you have this cucumber D size or this cucumber shape, then your action plan is to go ahead and bust out the Kama Sutra God inside of you and see what the two of you like best. Okay, also keep in mind that you may respond well to visual stimuli, and the more aroused you are, the firmer and the thicker the D gets, making it even hotter for both of you. Any position where you can get a full frontal view of your partner's body is also going to do you both good. So I suggest that you do the standing doggy in front of a full length mirror while you're penetrating your partner from behind, watching them from any angle at the same time and giving, you know, her twin tower a massage. You got that? Number four D shape is called the gherkin. This type of shape is undersized in girth and length, and a very small percentage of people are born with what's medically classified as congenital micro D or micro penises. This smaller size members measure like 3 inches or less when erect, and they're thought to be caused by low testosterone level during fetal development. And so for a woman that has a man with a micro D, it may be really hard for you to squeeze your kitty walls against it and feel stimulation, but it certainly does not mean that lovemaking can't be orgasmic inducing or orgasmic inducive. So don't get discouraged by it. As a man, you didn't create yourself. Don't be shy. There is someone who is always going to love you just the way you are. So this is what you have to do if you have a micro D. Focus on the positions that provide the best depth of penetration. All right, try putting pillow under your partner's bottom, and also try lifting up your legs over your shoulder while you're doing missionary. Okay, or have your partner just come on all fours on the bed while you stand above them so that you could pull their hips onto you, because this is like a modified version of plow. Do you get a modified version of you plowing? And lest I forget, oral and manual stimulation is going to be your thing. You can either use one to elicit an orgasm so that penetrative sex becomes less important, or you can bring them close to orgasm and then use penetration for completion. It's also worth considering using, you know, couples vibrator, one that is worn inside the kitty. But then again, positions and toys aside, someone with an undersized D might have, you know, penile anxiety that can lead to erectile dysfunction. Your adrenaline and other stress hormones can decrease blood flow to your D, making your erection less rigid and full. So relax your mind and don't put too much pressure or put too much thought to it, all right? You're good. Now, number 5D shape is called the rocket popsicle, all right? It's narrow at the head and it can have any length. This type of D shape is thicker at the base and it then narrows as you move upward. It's a totally normal variation as long as the narrowing isn't too drastic. If this is your shape type, then doggy style can feel, you know, pretty much fantastic for you and your partner, even if you're longer, cause narrowing of the tip reduces the chances of, you know, your tip hurting your partner as you enter. And since most sexual sensation comes from the tip of your D, and specifically the frenulum, more stimulation or pressure there will increase your pleasure as a man. So if your partner squeezes your pelvic floor while you're inside, it will further constrict the D and provide greater sensation for you. Do you get what I mean? Number 6 type of D shape is called the kielbasa. It's basically short and stout in nature. Now the truth is, regardless of the fact that a long D can be really arousing for some women, a thick one is more likely to contribute to a woman's orgasm. Am I lying? Women, If I'm lying, put it in a comment section. If you think I'm saying the truth, also put it in a comment section, right? The important thing for someone with a thick shottedy is choosing positions that give them leverage to go deeper. So your action plan could be just taking the standing downward doggy kind of pose, all right? Which works just like it sounds. Standing doggy kind of pose. Standing downward doggy kind of pose. Your partner just assumes a downward doggy position and you enter from behind. That's it. And to better stimulate the G-spot, try missionary position while you kneel and hold your partner's leg upward in a straddle position. And number 7th type of shape, which is actually the last one, is called the banana. Carved upwards or downwards. It can come in any girth. It typically has a longer length, and the truth is that longer D's often have natural curves, and these curves develop during puberty. Well, anything more than a 10 degrees curve though might be a sign of Peyronie's disease, which is caused by scar tissue along the D, usually due to an injury. And if the angle is greater than 25 degrees, then please see a doctor, all right? Because honestly, erections and penetration can be extremely painful for those with Peyronie's, and as a result of that, men with it may need medication or surgery to correct the curve. Now, if you have a banana type that has an upward curve, any position where you and your partner can face each other is going to perfectly align with the natural curve of the kitty. You can stand with your partner's legs wrapped around your waist, and you could hold her as she bounces up and down your D. It would give her so much sensation. This would give you more contact with her G-spot, which is on the front wall of the kitty. Now, for a banana shape with a downward curve, reverse cowgirl is a great position for the G-spot stimulation. And that's it. But the bottom line is this, right? It's not what you've got, it's how you use it. Just know that joystick of any shape, any size can deliver pleasure to any woman. You just need to know the right techniques, and that's it. Just go with what God has blessed you with. Thank you so much for watching, and I remain the juicy one. See you in my next video.